This is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. We're right in front of this cave. Hope we'll be okay. Our priest is a little damaged. We're not going over there. I think I already looked at that. Cool. Look at all these bones, man. Oh, the bones. Ice cave, right. Off of Long Watch Falls, so let's see what's in here.
Sure.
Glad you are so accommodating. Big open area for baddies to attack. There's something over there. Or 16 silver. There's an ice blight, but we don't have an option to fight it. Okay, we've already seen frost ooze, greater ice blights, two ice blights, greater ice blight, and ooze, and a logafeth in a pear tree. Ah! Hi. I should have rested. The dragon turns its head to look at you. Its red eyes are clouded like dirty ice, and its sides heave with labored breaths. Frosty plumes jet between its teeth. I had no idea I was going to be fighting a dragon at this point.
Leave. Now.
The only sound the dragon makes is a hoarse growl, but you hear it as clearly as if it were spoken language. The beast bares its teeth. Perception. You look ill.
I can still peel the flesh from your bones.
The dragon coughs, spattering the ice with crimson droplets. You see something femur-shaped stuck between its teeth. Huh. These are good, That's a goat. These are like goading it, I feel. Actually, at this point, I'd rather not fight it. I'd rather talk to it. What's the problem exactly?
Consider it indigestion. And consider yourself lucky I've eaten.
A belch rumbles up from the dragon's throat and reverberates in the ice under your feet. You know what? He's the soul twin. Or she. It? I don't know. Did you eat Igadir, the young man by the road?
Was that the rodent's name? I only know that he tasted mealy and lean.
The dragon probes the leg bone with its tongue. He came looking for his soul twin. What did that have to do with you?
Centuries I've lived. I won't share my soul with some mewling youth.
I knew it. The dragon gnashes its teeth. Wait, you're his soul twin? Why did you kill him?
While he lived, his suffering became mine. And as he drew closer, his weakness infected my essence.
I wish I could move up and see it more clearly.
I can never be strong while a soul twin of mine lives.
The dragon flicks its tail. Well, apparently you're still not strong. I don't think killing your soul twin made you stronger. Because the soul's not going to automatically go back in you. At least I don't think it works that way. If anything, it made you even more sick, unless you've always been like this. Well, I take it you've been through this before?
Since I was a worm, sudden fits of agony and terror would paralyze me. I was a prisoner to experiences that weren't mine.
The dragon's tail slowly coils and uncoils.
Eventually, I noticed something similar in my fellow hatchlings. I felt their cries and shrieks become mine as they nipped and flew at one another.
Go on.
I killed as many of the other hatchlings as I could. I felt their pain, But I also felt parts of their souls become mine.
Its slitted pupils widen at the memory.
I slaughtered and devoured, and the scent of blood drove my siblings into a frenzy. Our nest became a maelstrom of chaos as we fought, dying and feeding together. At last, only a handful of us were left. We were sickened by all we'd consumed and suffered.
The spines along its head flatten. What happened to the hatchlings that survived?
I eventually hunted down some of my missing siblings. Others returned to me in other skins and other lives, as that boy did.
Should we be understanding? Or should we tell the dragon it's wrong, it was wrong? Or we could just ask a question. Could you have grown stronger by uniting with your soul twins?
Remaining fettered to them, hoping they never think to turn on me.
I take that as a no. Something churns noisily in the dragon's stomach.
As interesting as this conversation has been, I've had enough of it.
The dragon picks at its teeth with a claw and finally pops the leg bone free. It chews on the morsel, its eyes fixed on you. You'll gain nothing from my soul. Why don't you focus on your soul twins? It looks at you, still crunching and splintering the bone between its teeth. Finally, it swallows the jagged mess.
Perhaps you're right.
Really?
Yet what will you offer me if I let you go?
Haha. It lowers its head to peer at you. Oh, we said worm, but not W-U-R-M. So that's an insult. Really, I could do that. What will you offer me if I let you go? Die, dragon! As a watcher, I could sever your connection with your soul twins.
Lies! You would make me vulnerable. How foolish I was to nearly fall for your tricks!
The dragon hisses and recoils. What have you got to lose by trusting me? Oh well, the dragon roars, flashing its fangs and claws as it prepares to attack. My. I predict our cleric will die shortly. Alright. We're not actually in combat yet. Let Canna deal with these. And the rest of us will attack the dragon. Interdiction, perhaps? I heard that's good. Every time I use it, I can't tell the difference, though. Okay. I cast it quick. Oh, there's more. What? There's specters now. Did you cast it already? Alright. Healing time. Oh my. ALS down. And we're still trying to get to the damn dragon. You know we're gonna die, but probably. But I'll have everyone fall back here, is what I'll do. At least I think. I can't see where else we'd go. Yeah, heal. Yeah. I don't know why I'm bothering. He's stunned.
I miss you, big fella.
Hello. Who are you talking to? Wow. I don't know if we can survive that. You might have to come back. All right, rest. All right. Sign the adventure. These things keep undoing themselves. I don't know if anyone else has had this problem. We've had the curtain walls for quite a while. They just uninstalled. Okay, so we did rest, right? Right.
I'm ready. I understand.
Move I'm up ready. A little.
Hey.
Adara's gonna be the one to go forward.
Yep. Yes.
Yes. Where's our friend Aloth? You'll hide behind.
What?
You'll hide behind.
Yeah. Sure.
Pretty much in the middle.
I'm ready.
Following your lead.
Hey.
Might not make it back.
All right, then.
If I take a different route, it looked like we started to get it on our side.
I can still peel the flesh from your bones.
If you wanted to kill me, you'd have tried already?
Careful. I killed the last wanderer I found in these parts.
Did you eat Igadir?
Was that the rodent's name? I only know that he tasted me. Centuries I've lived. I won't share my soul with some mule. While he lived, I can never be strong since I was a wolf. Eventually, I noticed something similar in my fellow hatchlings. I felt their cries and shrieks become mine as they nipped and flew at one another.
How did you become linked with your siblings?
I don't waste my time with the mysteries of souls. What sunders them and how the turning of the wheel apportions them. What matters is power. Survival. I killed as many of the other hatchlings as I could. I slaughtered and devoured. At last, only a handful of us were left. We were sickened by all we'd consumed and suffered.
I didn't think it was possible to consume the soul of another. Hold on a second, guys. Hold on.
Nor is it possible for most to feel the experiences of another so keenly. But it has always been this way with my soul twins. Our essence remains connected somehow. I eventually hunted down some of my missing siblings. Others returned to me in other skins and other lives, as that boy did.
Perhaps another of your soul twins has done the same. One day you may find yourself at the mercy of someone stronger.
As interesting as this conversation has been, I've had enough of it.
Hmm. You're still weakened. Save your strength and leave me be.
Perhaps you're right. If another soul twin like me... Yet what will you offer me if I let you go?
I've gathered plenty of treasure on my travels. I'll give you a share of it.
What use do I have for Kith trinkets? If you can offer me nothing better, then at least you'll satisfy my hunger.
Right? I don't know if there's anything I can say that would change its mind. Okay. Adair? Run back.
Hey.
Why are you running forward, Aloth? No, Aloth? My god. He just runs forward. I did not select him. I want to not have him run forward too much. Just enough to get the dragon involved. Can you run?
Hey.
Oh god. Okay, it's not gonna work that way. I'm not sure what to do. I guess I gotta cancel the interdiction. I would have liked to try it. Heal him. Disintegrate. Maybe I should have done crowd control. I don't think we'll last long enough. The spell's too slow. I don't think I have the resources to win this battle at this time, guys. I wonder how tough this dragon is compared to the dragon down below. In the endless pass of Adnua. I doubt he'll even make it through all these things. Begin your healing. Okay, boom, get him. Knock him down. Priest, do your thing. Hurry up, will ya? He's stunned. Okay. Release us. Priest still stunned, yes. Adair. Knock down a dragon. Okay. Keep healing. You gonna run all around him? That's not wise. Oh my god, Ken is out. Bring him back. I hate wasting it. Well, that's the wrong thing, no. There you go. Knock. Thank you. Take over the Spectre. Oh, Kanna has three. Will he regain his... Yeah, bring those skeletons in. What else can we do? Barely injured. Should I wait until I can bring a drake or something? Well, these, what is it? Three drakes? Three worms? That's a gambit. That's a gamble. It really is. I don't think we can knock that down. Oh, Ken is out again. Probably. I don't want to use that. Lay on hands, Kanna. Heal. Kanna. Probably won't work. If anything, you distracted the dragon for a little while. Still trying to cast, he's doing heal. Okay. Enervating terror. I don't think it works on these things, but it probably will work on a dragon. He can't go. What is he doing up here by the dragon, anyway? I think it's now or never. Bring. And if he dies, they're gonna disappear, right? The skeletons? Bring your skeletons. Or, what is this? Reducing damage reduction of enemies. Only by -5. Doesn't seem like a lot, does it? And... stunned. Let's do that instead. Because he might die and the skeletons will disappear, so let's do this. Oh, he's paralyzed! Damn it! Still paralyzed? Yep. Unless I use our other lay hands on him. Still barely injured. Wow. Terrified. Can he use it now? No, he's petrified. Great. Can I quickly kill the Spectre, maybe? Hannah's out. And what's her name? Palagina's out. Pretty epic song right here. Aloth. It's weakened, I guess, by this. How much does that do? 50-78 pierce? I don't think freeze will do much. 35-58, or... Okay. We'll do that. I'm like, where is everybody else? They've fallen. Oh, he's stunned. Alright. Good. Are you no longer stunned? Or are you still stunned? Barely injured still. Gaunt's pledge. Who just fell? Adair fell? Just like that? What? Where? How? Oh my god. Tail lash? Oh, and Theodos is out. Where's the part where Adair got hit by an extreme amount of damage or something? And why am I fighting the Ice Blight? Where was I? I don't know where it hit Adair for so hard. He seemed to be doing okay. Aeloth Endurance, huh? I know it's not worth it, guys. I know. I mean, debatable whether it's worth it. I want to see if I can get it down to regular injured. But I know we're not going to win it, is what I'm trying to say. Barely injured, yeah. Sorry, guys. Not working. I want to try these other options, though. Want to look around?
I've no patience for trespassing vermin. Go, or I'll gnaw the living flesh from your bones.
You're barely staying on your feet. I think you're too weak to fight me.
Careful. I killed the last wanderer I found in these parts.
What's the problem exactly?
Consider it indigestion. And was that the rodent's name? I only know that he tasted mealy and lean.
Then why do you look injured? He didn't seem like much of an adversary.
I killed him with one swipe of my claws, while he stared at me with those vacant lamb's eyes.
It digs its talons into the snow.
But his soul shared a connection with mine, one that left me strained, briefly.
It fixes its slit pupiled eyes on you. He thought you could ease his suffering.
Didn't I?
The dragon's mouth stretches into something that could almost be a grin.
While he lived, his suffering became mine. I can never be strong while a soul twin of mine lives. Since I was a worm, eventually I noticed something similar in my fellow I killed as many of the other hatchlings as I could. I slaughtered and devoured. At last, only a handful of us were left. We were sickened by all we'd consumed. I eventually hunted down some of my missing siblings. Others returned to me in other skins and other lives, as that boy did.
I understand. You do what you must to survive.
Indeed. As interesting as this conversation has been, I've had enough of it. I'll take my chances. Others returned to me in other skins and other lives, as that boy did.
Caution is the crutch of the weak. It pays to strike first.
As interesting as this conversation has been, I've had enough of it. Perhaps you're right. Yet what will you offer me if I let you go? Lies! You would make me vulnerable. How foolish I was to nearly fall for your tricks!
You're weakened even now. Let me help you. I'll try the other one. Oh, that's save.
Lies! You would make me vulnerable. How foolish I was to nearly fall for your tricks!
So maybe this option turns this around? Otherwise, the only other option is, I mean you no harm. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Obviously, I can't fight this thing yet. I suppose I'll be back at one point. Same as I'll be back to fight the dragon at the end, at the bottom of the Endless Paths of Adnua. And same as I'll be back to fight, what's his name, at the actual end of the game. Those are the last two I'm going to save for the end of, what do you call it? The White March Part 2. But for now, next episode we'll head back to Starwood Village and finish our quests, wrap up some quests there, and we'll move onward to Durgan's Battery from there. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.